In this tutorial, I will show you how to animate a static arrow in Premiere and how we can add this animated arrow to our videos or images. You can use animated arrows to make your videos point to the points where we want them to be the center of attention and focus attention of those points. We don't want to see the background as a white image. It would be much more advantageous to find a transparent arrow for it. After under this arrow, you can add a video or even a photo consisting of a single frame. Let's set them and let's start our tutorial right away. First of all, let's examine what is in the scene. An arrow in PNG format and the image itself. We will use Premiere's layer feature to place this arrow onto the image. We will put this image on the background and bring the arrow on it. After positioning the arrow on the image, let's edit it immediately. I am scaling it down a little bit. And I play with its position and choose where to point it. Where should we take it? Let's base it on this area. Let's make it point to this area. For this, you have to move it a little bit to the right. This way is enough. We will give movement to the arrow using keyframe method. Let's expand the effects control panel a bit. We will need the timeline of this panel. Let's move the timeline to the first part and move the arrow a little bit to the left by moving the value on the left. And give it a keyframe. We have given the keyframe. When the keyframe is given, you will see a sign here. When I zoom in like this, or even change its position, you will see a sign here. Let's press Shift Right twice on the keyboard. So we will move 10 frames. And this time, I'm dragging the arrow here to the starting position. Again, using the value on the left. That's done. Now let's move 10 more frames by pressing Shift Right arrow twice again, or just pressing the right arrow 10 times. I'm pressing the right arrow twice. I'm taking the first keyframe that I created here with the Alt key. I'm pressing Alt on the keyboard and I'm dragging it over here. What do we get from what we have done so far? We are looking at this arrow. We have got this kind of orientation. Now we will continue keyframing. When I am on this keyframe, I click Shift Right arrow twice again. I move forward another 10 frames and select these two keyframes and press Alt on the keyboard. And when we direct these keyframes multiply. So, that's what we are doing. Again, I press the Alt key and select these two keyframes and direct them to the right, so that we duplicate the same keyframes here. Now, I will do the same again. I hover over the next keyframe, and you can switch to the next keyframe by clicking on this little arrow here. In the same way, you can use this to switch to the previous keyframe. I click on the arrow on the right, and this time, I'm moving 10 frames again. Select 4 of them. Press the Alt key and duplicate them like this again. You can shrink the timeline here by scrolling here. Now let's check. Let's see how the edits we have made so far give us a result. The movement is showing the relevant point, but it is showing it a little bit harshly. Now we will soften it a little bit. Click on this little arrow next to the position. This is where it shows us how to make the movements. I select all keyframes and right click and select Easy In under this option. Then I do the same thing again. I select Easy Out under the Temporal Interpolation option. And now I check it again. And you can see that instead of the hard transitions that we had before, it now gives a much more smoother transition. And the arrow pointing to the relevant focal point there is much smoother. This way you can use it more extensively after you have prepared your movement. Now if I click Rotate, let's assume I set 90 degrees. This movement will still continue on this horizontal axis. This is not something we want. So I right click on the animation we made, that is on the PNG file, on the layer and select the nest option. Nest option is a feature used in the smart object method in Photoshop in Premiere. I click OK. This time I play it again. The animation is working properly and when I rotate it, let's give the example of 90 degrees again. Now when I play it again, this time I can use it as I want. So nest gives me this possibility. Even if it is 45 degrees, it allows me to use it the way I want. If I wish, I can also use it from different angles by changing its position. Of course, the reason why this is here is that we have made a few keyframes. We can increase this. Again, I double click inside the nest and select this option. As you can see, this time, the arrow is visible, but the other sides are not visible, because we only took the nest of the arrow. When I enlarge the screen a little bit more, we can extend the logic we just did if you want. I don't select the last keyframe. I don't select the keyframe at the beginning. I select all of them. I move forward twice, so I move forward 10 frames and I have duplicated it here. Now let's see again if it works properly from now on. It is working exactly the same. Now I close this sequence. Right click on it and click close panel. And when I check here, I will be able to see that it is getting longer. After 4, it continues again because we have made it go on for 4 more times. It stops after 8 times. It is possible to extend it with the method we just did. In this Premiere tutorial, I showed you how to animate the arrow image in PNG format that we found on the internet. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.